apologize to Kelly. That little routine I did, that Mommy Dearest thing, some of us belong in a padded cell. But as Fausto said, these are tough times. And as Fausto said, these are tough times, and we all have to be like tempered steel. And tempered steel, if you extrude it, and if you pull it like a taffy pull, turns into metal wire. So we don't need padded hangers. Wire hangers will do. Cabby?
Cabby!
Yeah.
Cabby, please come out.
What's that?
Hurry!
Hurry the fuck out!
I'm trying to be nice here. Take those frickin' apples off your head and get out of here. I'm losing my patience.
Holy cow!
There you are.
Sorry, I had to switch my wig.
That's okay. Wait, just don't sit on my ukulele. Don't sit on my ukulele with anybody else but me. I just wanted to give this back to you, and I wanted to say that I'm sorry that I hurt you before. I understand that being a wren has its responsibilities, and that part of my responsibility is to allow you to live your truth. And I'd like to sing for everybody. Hey, can you be my mic holder since Winona ain't here?
Sure, but can Kit do it?
Sure can.
Oh, wait.
Can Kit's sister do it?
Kit, can you do it?
Sure can. Everybody thinks I'm Pink Fairy anyway.
There used to be a show in Chicago a long time ago when there were about three things on TV. One really was a show called The Blue Fairy. This is the days of live TV, and my wonderful friend, the late George Nelly, who was a puppeteer in the early days of Disney, was actually, he was a fairy anyway, but he was the Blue Fairy. And Bridget Baslin, who was the daughter of, not Maggie Daly, the wife of the mayor, but Maggie Daly, the columnist, was the princess who would sit and talk with the Blue Fairy. And actually, it was Bridget Baslin who was in the audience at the Gate of Horn when Lenny Bruce said cocksucker. And the Gate of Horn was shut down, and so was he. I just said cocksucker, and it felt really good, but I'll tell you something. We do live in times when that might not be possible soon. That's a first world issue. We have babies in cages. I just saw that, first of all, they really are calling one of the camps El Presidente. Miguel, who was here before and left with my friend Ralph, suggested that they call them Dachau and Birkenau and Majdanek and Treblinka, which happened to be one of the camps in the Jewish Holocaust, and there have been many Holocausts, but that was used as the model camp. So then when the press came through, the orchestra played, and there were ballerinas, and there were, you know, folks that seemed all quite civilized and healthy and well. And who knows, probably at Camp El Presidente, they'll have a little Carl Orff orchestra using little plastic instruments and playing little songs, and hopefully that won't go on for more than a week or two. I know that I'll be one of the people chained to the fences, and I hope other people will join me. I think they said they're now not calling the children under three infants anymore. They're calling them tender ones, or children of tender age, Trump administration, which made me think of Jonathan Swift and A Modest Proposal. And so I wondered if the next camp was Camp Johnsonville. Anyway,
in the early days of television, there was a show called Here's Geraldine, which was quite lovely. Geraldine was a puppet giraffe. They pretty much used one person and a puppet in a single set and a single camera. But they played a little song that you were supposed to learn about being nice to your parents. And I didn't know until today when I looked up the lyrics on YouTube that it was written by my friend, the wonderful commie folk singer Keith Siegel. And I'm changing just a few words.
Cheaper, and you know what? I could probably get Medicare to pay for this.
It is doctor approved. It is.